Well, cricket may be an aggressive game, but अगर कोई ऐसे player है जिन्हें बुलाते हैं hitman, but is known to be calm and composed on the field, well, it would have to be Rohit Sharma. I am at India's biggest meditation center, Kana Shantivanam, जहाँ heartfulness meditation practice होती है, and I'm going to meet Rohit Sharma, Mumbai ka mulka, for a Sunday brunch where I'll be discussing cricket as well as meditation.
Born in Nagpur, but you are the Mumbai cha mulka who has traveled through local trains Borivali to Churchgate. I mean, how much more authentic can it get? सबसे ज़्यादा क्या अच्छा लगता है आपको मुंबई के बारे में?
यही local trains. I cannot forget. Every growing kid who aspires to be a cricketer has to go through all that. I think when I sit back now and think about all those things, I find it. You know, I actually miss those things. I used to travel with my buddies, with my friends. So it was more like an experience and we used to enjoy that ride.
Last kab travel kiya tha aapne local train?
Kaafi time ho gaya hai usko abhi. Actually 6-7 saal ke upar ho gaya.
Really? पर आपने 10 साल 12 साल पहले डेब्यू किया था क्रिकेट, तो आप एक पॉपुलर होने के बाद भी आपने ट्रैवल किया?
हाँ, मैंने किया है, क्योंकि we know in Mumbai the traffic is a killer and if you want to save time it's the best way.
गलियों में क्रिकेट खेला है और कितने कांच तोड़े हैं आपने?
बहुत तोड़े. हम दोपहर में खेलते थे जो हमारे नेबर्स को पसंद नहीं था, क्योंकि हम काफ़ी शोर मचाते थे. कांचे भी टूटी है, पुलिस भी आई है हमें डांटने के लिए.
हो, पुलिस भी आई है?
हाँ, काफी बार आई है.
वड़ा पाव, सेवपुरी, मिसल पाव, इन सब के बारे में आपका क्या ख्याल है?
आई लव इट. अभी भी खाता हूँ जब भी मन करता है, क्योंकि ये एक चीज़ है वो मेरे अंदर से कभी नहीं जाएगा, क्योंकि मैं बचपन से ये सब खा कर बड़ा हुआ. बट ऑब्वियसली नाउ यू हैव टू कीप इन माइंड यू नो दैट यू आर एन एथलीट एंड यू नीड टू मेक श्योर दैट यू आर ईटिंग राइट एट द राइट टाइम. बट ये सब खाने का अपना एक टाइम होता है और जब मिलता है टाइम तो मैं बिल्कुल एंजॉय करता हूँ ये.
और आप मुंबई इंडियंस की टीम के लिए आई हैव हर्ड ड्रेसिंग रूम में सारा स्ट्रीट फूड मंगवाते हैं?
जी बिल्कुल, क्योंकि हमारे जो फॉरेन प्लेयर्स हैं वो काफ़ी एंजॉय करते हैं ये स्ट्रीट फूड. उनको ये पानी पूरी और भेलपूरी, शेव पूरी, ये सब बहुत पसंद है. तो हम जब इकट्ठा होते हैं टूर्नामेंट के पहले, तो एक हमारा एक सेशन होता है स्ट्रीट फूड का पूरी टीम के लिए, और एक तरीके से वो गेट टुगेदर भी हो जाता है, क्योंकि सारे लड़के एक साथ आ जाते हैं और काफ़ी एंजॉय करते हैं.
सो मैं आपके टेस्ट बड्स टेस्ट करने वाली हूँ. आई एम गोइंग टू ब्लाइंड फोल्ड यू एंड यू हैव टू गेस एंड टेल मी व्हाट इज इट दैट यू आर ईटिंग. ओके, कैन वी डू दैट? ऑलराइट. Foods here. Here you go. Chota sa bite hai.
Ye puri hai.
No.
Shave to taste kiya hai maine. So shave puri to nahi hai ye.
Nahi, ye shave puri nahi hai. Main ek aur bite dun aapko.
Yes, please.
Go.
Ye mera favorite hai.
Nahi, ye aapka favorite shayad nahi hai.
Acha.
Actually, I'll have to ask Ritika. Ritika, क्या ये इनका favorite है? No.
Kachori?
Well, something similar. This was samosa.
Oh, अच्छा.
ये आपका favorite है? Oh, you can feel it now.
Thepla?
Is thepla your favorite?
Paratha है क्या?
Yes.
मेरे दोस्त इतने नॉर्थ इंडियंस हैं तो पराठा मेरा कुछ टाइम के लिए फेवरेट हो ही जाता है.
वेरी गुड. सो यू गेस्ट इट राइट. दिस इज आलू पराठा. अच्छा, वी आवर नेक्स्ट डिश इज हियर. ये लीजिए. सो गुड स्ट्रेटजी है, आप स्मेल कर रहे हैं पहले.
किनोवा जैसे कुछ?
यस, दैट्स राइट. मतलब आपको हेल्दी फूड ज्यादा पता है. वी आर डन विद द गेम. यू अर्नड योर फूड रोहित. यू कैन ऑल्सो एंजॉय इट नाउ इफ यू लाइक. सो इज देयर अ लॉट ऑफ फूड डिसिप्लिन इन योर लाइफ नाउ?
बिल्कुल. आई मीन For any athlete, it is important. You got to keep an eye on it, what you eat and all that. But at the same time, you got to enjoy the food because there's so much variety.
मुझे ये बताओ, अगर आपका heart बोलता है सेवपुरी खाना है या वड़ा पाव, और head बोलता है किनोवा खाना है, आप किसकी सुनते हो?
मैं दोनों की सुनता हूँ, but again, फिर next day मेरा माइंड बोलता है कि सुबह को जल्दी उठना है और जाके रनिंग करना है.
But there's always a conflict between head and heart. So now I'm going to be inviting an expert who has been, you know, practicing heartfulness meditation.
Yes.
जो हमें बताएंगे how to win this battle and how to understand this better. And he is the master of spiritual meditation. So let's call popular Kamlesh D. Patel, also very affectionately called Taji. I'm sitting with two silent change makers. He is the master of high pressure game cricket. He is the master of spiritual meditation. Rohit, I would like you to meet Daji. And thank you so much for joining us our Sunday brunch. I know you are Gujarati. So, kya aapka bhi koi favorite food hai? Do you like dhokla, thepla, or anything like that?
I enjoy all kinds of foods. Especially when Gujarati food is the relish people's childhood habits.
Okay, so he's a fan of vada pav. What about you? I want to know which is your favorite food.
I like vada pav too.
Really?
Anything with potatoes, I love.
Oh, we have some samosa here and aloo paratha.
Yes.
Have you seen him play on the cricket field?
Last three games I followed very systematically against New Zealand. I like his style and I foresee him to be the star in the world. So I like his calmness, I like his composure, I like the way he tackles under pressure.
Right.
Which is rare. Not many people, many players can come up with such a tactic.
We play such a high profile sport and it requires a lot of calmness to make tactical decisions, to understand your teammate also what he is going through. Because when I'm captaining Mumbai Indians, I'm just not thinking about myself. I have to think about the rest of my 10 teammates who are on the field and how best I can get out of them. You know, that is what a leader should be doing or thinking in that fashion.
I know ki field par kai baar sledging hoti hai, right? You know, where there's lot of negativity. How do you tackle a situation like this?
Shuru mein itna aasan nahi hota tha kyunki when you are just entering the scene, when you just started playing, obviously you are overwrought by the situation and the surroundings around you, but then you got to realize that that is not what you're here for. You're here for making your country proud, and how you will do that is by performing. Back then, people used to talk about West Indies all the time, that they were so intimidating and, you know, to win against them was so difficult. And then in early 2000s, it was Australia. And I think now, it's fair to say that it's India, because we have done actually comfortably well in all three formats. Unfortunate incident that we couldn't win the World Cup. But I thought, over the year, if you look at the performance, I think we've done reasonably well.
So we are at this Heartfulness Center where we often speak about meditation. But to inculcate a habit like meditation, it's especially in the youth, you know, jahan itne sare distractions hai, how is it that you would transform this habit, because you want to spread this? How do we get or find a right mix of the two?
Youth has to know what benefits can be out of doing the meditation. Right? When stars like him are meditating and shining out with their performance in the cricket field. If the students, when you compare them, students meditating and students not meditating, and see their performance in the field of education, or a businessman meditating versus not meditating. In all situations, people who meditate, they stand out taller than the rest of the gang. One has to admit this. Even science speaks about all these things today. How various neurotransmitters in the brain plays out when you are meditating. You're reaching out to your own higher self with yoga. And when you are in such a state, when you are in the flow with yourself, things happen very naturally. You can see him play in the flow. It's as if he's meditating. For him, that playing cricket has become meditation.
Is that right, Rohit?
Yeah. As soon as I enter the field, it's just a different ball game. It's just a piece. Of course, when you're playing, there's a pressure. There is expectation. There is everything which relates to cricket. But like I said, I've learned to keep them away and just focus on the job. And yes, but now if the kids are told about all these things, how it can help you make good decisions on the field, not just on the field but also in the classroom when they're sitting
in your study, life in general.
In your life in general.
You're a father now.
Yeah, absolutely. So I want my daughter also to meditate, but not now. She's too young for it now. But yeah.
Okay. How has life changed after being a father?
Life has not. I mean, it's pretty much the same except the sleep. I guess rest, everything is the same.
And how often do you meditate to begin with?
I do it on the field.
Okay.
I do it in the dressing room. And in the hotel room when I am there, and in fact in the flight as well, and also you know when I am on the field as well, like I close my eyes and think about not thinking about anything. That is what I think, because that helps me make decisions on the field.
Right, Raji, I think that's one of the most difficult things is to not think about anything. You know, even when I have tried meditating and I can speak with my experience, I close my eyes for the first maybe 30-40 seconds, okay, I can have a blank mind, and suddenly there is like, you know, there's so many thoughts coming over. What does meditation actually mean, and what is the kind of state of mind you need to be in?
Well, there is no really prerequisite before you start meditation.
I'll share with you a story. I was a young boy. He saw a man flying in the sky. This goes back to some Tibetan stories. And seeing the old man flying, he also wanted to fly. Begs him to teach him how to fly like a bird.
As promised by Sannyasi, he said, I will teach you all this on the full moon night. You'll have to meditate. So full moon night came, auspicious night, and he was eagerly waiting. Then the teacher says to him, go back home, and when the moon is right above your head, take shower and sit for meditation. But make sure you don't think of anything. Before meditation, he promises himself, I'm not supposed to see a monkey. I'm not supposed to see a monkey. And all through the meditation, he spoils his meditation by not thinking about monkey, but he thinks over it. So meditation should have a free approach. Whatever thought comes, let them come. Gently train your mind to rest it on a divine thought, on an auspicious thought. You have witnessed brighter mind, right? It's a disruption in the field of education. And so is this heartfulness practice. I would say it's a disruption in the field of yoga. It changes everything.
Now that you bring this up, just before you came, we played a blindfolding test your taste buds game with Rohit. And luckily, 2 out of 3, he guessed it right.
I thought it would be 3 out of 3.
Yeah, he said this is kachori. So it was pretty close. But what I saw yesterday was very interesting, where I saw that the kids were blindfolded and they could guess the color or even could read what's written on a piece of paper. How does that work? Is that the intuitive mind that builds, or what is it?
Well, through these brighter mind techniques, we develop their brain. The brain power is somehow exposed. They're able to observe things with closed eyes. And the trans-sensory perception happens. Something that you are able to see with your eyes, now you are able to smell with your nose. You saw him when he was trying his food. His smelling food also tells you somehow what my eyes could have seen.
Rohit, do you have such moments on the field when you are batting kar rahe hain and you get an intuition ki kis tarah se ball aayega aur how do you tackle? Do you have such moments?
In cricket, you got to stay ahead of the game. When I'm on the field, when I'm batting especially, when you play a ball, obviously there is a little time that you get because the bowler is going back to his run up, and that is the time I just take a moment and think about what I need to do next and what the bowler is going to do to me. So that calmness for that 2-3 seconds is very important at that stage.
Koi role model hai? Do you think there's somebody else also like you who remains calm, who you really look up to?
I mean, see, the whole India knows MS Dhoni is the one who is been like that, and I think it's again, it's inborn, and again it has helped him to make such good decisions on the field. And now you see he's the most successful Indian captain, having all 3 ICC trophies with him, you know, and many IPL titles as well. So it's the best captain India has seen. So obviously there is a reason behind it, and that reason to me is, you know, him being calm and composed under the situation, pressure situation. And I have seen him handle a lot of younger bowlers when they get under pressure. What I mean, just he just goes around and puts his arm around their neck and talks to them about what he needs to do and what not. And you know, when a younger player is being treated like that by a senior member of the team, you obviously feel confident and you want to deliver them for the team.
In fact, Daji also comes from a corporate background. He has had a great career in pharmacy back in the US, and I'm sure you've also dealt with the real life corporate issues of dealing with clients, or like Rohit mentioned, managing a team. Are there any life lessons that you have through that experience?
However trained you may be in any field, but there is always unpredictability. The most inevitable thing can appear when you least expect it, which nobody has taught you. But your inner guidance will be so profound because you tend to remain calm, your intuition is hyper up, and your courage that builds up over a period of time, that each time I follow my heart, I'm always successful. So this gives you confidence.
Do you listen to your heart?
Of course, because it's the most important thing, especially when you are in trouble, when you don't know what to do next. There will be an inside voice that will come out and say, this is what you should do. And you just have to go with that.
Now, after listening to both of you, I'm definitely going to try meditating at the Heartfulness Institute. What is the procedure? Is there a program, an agenda? Is there a fees? How does this work?
We don't charge anybody. This, all these practices we teach to the world. It is at a zero cost.
Wow, how is it possible? You can come stay here, meditate, eat, and you don't charge?
Don't charge. Brahma Vidya has to be for free. Most vital things are always free. The moment we start charging, that essence is totally lost. Especially I'm requesting the youth, abandon those guys who are charging you money, because Brahma Vidya has to be free.
Yeah, well, it's totally a priceless experience, and you have to try it to believe it, which I think you just tried meditating in the heartfulness way. So how was that experience?
Lightheaded. It's just, I feel so light, relaxed, and the atmosphere here is so, like, as soon as I entered the premises, it was just, I was surrounded with positivity, which is what everyone needs in their life.
Ours is a travel platform, and I want to ask a couple of questions around travel as well. Do you like traveling?
Of course, we love traveling.
What about you, Daji? Do you like traveling?
I used to.
Not anymore?
Not anymore.
Which has been your most favorite place that you've been to till date?
My favorite is Europe. Anywhere in Europe is my favorite, and I do love Maldives as well.
You've traveled all around India as well, your favorite place?
I actually can't think anything beyond Mumbai.
Oh, high five. I'm also from Mumbai.
Yeah, I love Mumbai because if I have to spend a day in another country, in another city in Mumbai, it'll be challenging for me.
Okay. I'm going to play a fun game with both of you before we wrap this. It's called 5 Second Fire. I'll be giving 5 seconds to you and you have to give me an answer. Name 3 baby products that Ritika or you always have in the bag while traveling.
Water wipes. Water wipes, Aveeno, and Baby Zen. Not in the bag, but it's a pram. But it's always with us, so it counts.
Okay. I think you went, this is beyond 5 seconds. Okay. Daji, for you, okay? Name 3 practices that can help in relaxing one's mind.
Well, you can play cricket, you can play table tennis, games. You can cycle, you can read, you can listen to music and meditate.
Wow, I asked for 3, Daji gave me 5. That was quick. Okay. Rohit, to you, name 3 cricketers you last spoke with.
Hardik Pandya. Actually, Hardik Pandya, because he got engaged recently.
Oh, okay.
And I don't remember any. Kuldeep Yadav, he messaged me wishing me New Year's, and the other one, only 2 I guess.
Okay.
I know, again, this went beyond 5.
Taji, name 3 celebrities you think who need to start meditating.
Who need to start meditating? Celebrities? I don't know any celebrities.
Come on.
I am out of this field. I don't pay attention to the celebrities.
No? Okay. Name three food dishes you can eat anytime.
Poha,
Sabudana Khichdi, and then these two I can eat anytime.
Three qualities of a calm person.
Compassion, empathy, love.
I'm losing this.
You are definitely losing
this. But we are not playing game here.
Do you want to meditate? For 2 minutes before we start. Okay, you have another 2 questions to go. So Rohit, name three of your favorite Bollywood actors.
Hrithik, Ranveer and Ajay Devgan. I like his acting.
Three of your favorite cricket players.
Oh my God.
One is easy.
Yes, he is all-time favorite actually. He's top number one. Yeah. Another is Dolly and of course Tendulkar.
Oh, okay. All three really calm and composed on the field. Well, I have to say it's been wonderful playing this game as well as enjoying the Sunday brunch with both of you. Thank you very much.
You.
It's always heart over mind. Is that right?
Always, always.
Listen to your heart is the advice coming in from both these silent change makers. Thank you.